I joined the beginning of my sophomore year.
And how has your experience been?
Well, it's track, so it's hard, but I like it.
How are the workouts?
The workouts, we do like a difficult day and then an easy day. So the easy days are really chill. We'll just go off campus and do mileage.
Let's go, Anya!
Let's go, Anya! Woo! So then, like, the hard workouts, usually we have track stuff, so tempos and intervals training on the track, which tends to be a little more difficult, but it's still doable, especially when you have, like, teammates to push you and to work with.
Hello, my name is Katie Saunders. I joined track and field my sophomore year. I came here from softball, and I think it's probably one of the best decisions I've ever made. Joining track has put me in the best shape I've ever been in my whole life. It's given me a family of people that I would do anything for. They're my favorite people in the world. I love it. I ran sprints my sophomore year. But now I do shot put and discus, and I'm captain of the track and field team. So, yeah, I have no complaints about the track team at all, none whatsoever.
What's the hardest part?
The hardest part about, is probably trying to convince other people to throw. Because when you think of track and field, you think of running, you think of pole vault. But no one thinks of weightlifting and shot put and discus. So I've worked as hard as I can to recruit some freshmen, sophomore seniors, and some seniors. But once I graduate, I hope that there's still a shot put and discus team.
Fuck, that was a hard workout.
I have been coaching probably for about 12 years now.
And what do you like most about it?
13 years now, actually. What do I like most about it is having the ability to make a positive influence on young people's lives in a multitude of ways.
As a track coach, what do you think is important for these runners to learn?
I think what's important for them to learn is that what they learn on the track and what they learn in the weight room is the same exact thing that they're gonna have to. They're not gonna have a choice, but they have to apply the same things to life. The ability to finish races, and no matter how good or bad you're doing, the ability to come back from trials and tribulations, everything that's involved in the sport and training for the sport is something that can be applied to life, and it's something that I make sure that they understand. That if they have the fortitude to do what's necessary here to be successful, they have the fortitude.
What's a typical day like for you and your athletes on the track?
A typical day, usually it starts with about 3 to 4 styles, mostly 3 different styles of stretching. Heavy stretching is a very necessary. Training without getting injured is what I kind of specialize in. And it starts with a heavy stretch, about 40 minutes. It moves on to some core work, and it moves on to other types of muscle groups that I decide to target for the day specifically, or sometimes I will do all technique. Sometimes I do a combination of workout plus technique, usually is it.
And these are for your throwers,
those
correct?
Those are for my throwers, correct.
Now, how would you apply this to the other track athletes?
Well, in the weight room, for the most part, or when we get together as a group and do some core activity, or like I did for cross-country season, as far as having doing strength and conditioning on the field with them, as well as flexibility and core.
Bye, guys!
So I joined track 4 months ago, so I've been doing it for a total of 4 months. I run the 4... And the most rewarding part of track is PRing and
I would not be on track.
Just being able to constantly improve and working hard.
How's your experience been?
Okay, so far my experience has been so awesome. I love track so much. I've made so many new friends and I love the group. We've become really close and we're always talking, we're always laughing, but we're also always working hard and we're always having a lot of fun.
What's the worst part?
The worst part is when you feel like you want to throw up afterwards, and in some cases people do throw up.
I like the satisfaction of running the race with the adrenaline pumping and you're neck to neck with someone and stop making fun of me. And just the teamwork, because I love the team, and it's great.
How are the workouts?
My honest opinion, if you went to hell, that would be more pleasant than our workouts.
How often does someone throw up?
Every day. What do you mean?
Tupelo, what are you mad about?
I'm mad that Ellie doesn't get to run off campus on her birthday.
I don't fucking run. But we can do four.
Let's go.
Take that. The world is dying, but it's always dead.
Always.
But it's never fucking dead.
Oh, track's kind of like a hobby. It's a little pointless.
Like 70.
But I'm good at it. I've been doing it for years. I don't know what I do with my time I didn't do on be on track.
What?
Okay, what about your honest opinion?
What?
Your honest opinion.
That is it. It's pointless, but I do it.
Socked Mason in the back so hard.
Aww, where is he?
And then they called the trainer and he said that he's paralyzed.
Right, also in the middle of throwing up going on.
What do you want to know
finishing
about?
That 800,
but we're also, the suicide hill is every single moment of our lives and our lives are forever.
No.
Okay, now truly though, how do you feel about track?
It's good.
Track relates to life. Your whole life is one big race.
No.
Because every step is just one lap. No. It's all one big race. When you are born, the gun goes off, and when you die, that's when it's over. If you love somebody, better tell them why they heat. They just may run away from you. You'll never know what when. Well, then again, it just depends on how long your time is left for you.
What's your favorite part?
The people are definitely my favorite part of track and field. Yeah,
definitely.
I don't know what I'd do without them. So yeah.